Welcome jewelry makers, and this is the next video from Serena, and this is the bracelet we are going to make today. A lovely bracelet with the charming murano beads, Pandora style. Why I didn't ask you to buy these beads in my first video? First of all, these are expensive beads, and actually there is no need to buy so many crafts. Just I want to show you on the video variety of crafts which is available in the stores, just to give you some knowledge, but it's not really needed. So you can match the beads, murano beads, with any other beads you have. Also today I'm gonna use lapis lazuli beads around 12 millimeter. And small beads of prenit around 6 millimeters, faceted beads, very beautiful. It's actually my favorite stone, very good in lithotherapy. And a bit smaller, around 1 centimeter size, lapis lazuli beads. It's a very good quality, not colored. And murano beads, very beautiful shape and mixed colors with a big hole between. It's Pandora style bead. Actually, they're using for bracelet on the thick metallic cord, but it's not really needed. You can use it in ordinary bracelet or necklaces as today. And opening rings, calots, crimps, and silver plated balls around 3 millimeter size, pins, so let's start with the thread. You need to cut a piece of thread size like your arm plus 8 centimeters, like this length. Don't make it small, otherwise you won't be able to fix ends. So we're gonna start our central bead bracelets without counting beads. I will show you how. Just take the liner and find out the size of your own arm by thread, any thread. So my one is 17 and 3 centimeters, like that. Then I take paper, ordinary size, and fix it with the sewing pins from both sides. One side is thicker, other side is thinner. So this is the size controller. Very simple but very useful. And now you see what we're gonna do. I'm taking the thread the same size as my arm. Now I hold the ends and put it over the size controller, like this. This is my arm, the thickness of my arm. And then I slide it to the from thin side to thick side until the thread stops moving. So my one stops moving here, so that means that here is my size. So just I write here that this is my size. You can make many of these, just four different sizes if you generally make bracelets for different people. So now we have a size controller, so we don't need to count beads before starting. I don't like counting beads. I prefer to create the design in process of work. So that's why I start with the center. I put the central bead on the thread like this. Now it's sliding, you see? It must not slide, so that's why I have to fix it somehow. That's why I will use beads. Stone beads. I'm taking the biggest ones. When you're making jewelry, biggest beads always should be in the center. So that's how I fix it. And now I will use the silver plated beads for decoration and to make it more shining look. Today I will use 3 murano beads for one bracelet. I could use 1, I could use 5. Generally they are 5 in pack, like these beads. So that's why 2 I use for earrings, 3 I use for bracelet. But anyway, it's a bracelet with the center, because I have 3 beads. 1 in center, 2 from both sides. Now I add the printed beads. Generally I prefer to fix the Pandora style beads by small stone beads size around like a hole of murano bead. It's around 5 or 6 millimeters if I do a long like necklace, for example. But length of the bracelet is very small and I want to show all the beads I have in center. So that's why I will mix all variety of beads in the central part. So I add the biggest beads of lapis lazuli, so the center is finished and now the beads will be smaller. These beads are expensive, all of them, and each lesson I will try to give you a variety of beads just to make you learn different names of stones. And after all, in the end of part 1 of our tutorials, I will make an extra lesson where we're gonna speak about all the stones we used in a part 1, just to give you extra information, especially for someone who likes natural stones and I want to get more knowledge about them. So I add smaller lapis lazuli beads and I near to finish the bracelet. Now I will add some printed beads. There we are. I think so. So here is the size we need. But I need to make sure. I need somebody's hand. But I don't have anybody at home with my arm size. So that's why I use the size controller. I could use my own arm, but this is a huge risk to spread all the beads around the table. So that's why. Generally, jewelry makers counting how many beads they need in the first before starting the design. But I'm using the size controller, so that's why it's very useful. And I see how many beads I need more to finish the design. Beads must not touch each other on the controller, because we will need extra space for lockets, rings and calottes, which is around 2 centimeters. It depends on size of your locket and rings and calottes. They could be different size, so, but around 2-2.5 centimeters extra. So I think so that is it. Plus I will add the chain. So that should be enough. I will link around 4 rings to the calotte, so this should be perfect size. I am professional, so I can use my hand, especially on the soft fuzzy towel where beads not moving properly. I suggest you to do the same if you work on a table, not on the on the box as I suggested you. But beginners should be very careful about. So I put the calotte from inside to outside as I shown you in my first lesson, and now I'll add some crimp for fixing thread, and then I will do everything as I usually do. Be careful now to not lose the beads from other side. So I put the crimp. Now I squeeze it by pliers and fixing thread properly. And now I make a knot over the crimp. You see how it looked like. I'm not going to show this process step by step any lesson, because those ones who was looking all the videos, they know how to do it. I can give you techniques, but unfortunately I cannot give you experience and enthusiasm, of course. This is depends on you only. Just I pull the knot and the knot is ready. I cut off the rest of the thread without damaging the knot, of course. And now I slide all the beads down. All the work I'm doing very carefully. I'm not pulling the thread to not lose the beads from the other side. Now everything is ready. I close the calotte with my hands because the metal of my calotte is very soft, so I can do it with my own fingers. If yours one is thick, you can use flat noses or close it gently. And now I do the same with the other side. I put the calotte from inside to outside and the crimp. Yeah. So I pull all the beads down. Especially when you're making Pandora style beads, this is very important that there is no space between beads, otherwise the Murano glass beads, they'll slide and it will look awful, and you would have to start everything from the beginning. So now I'm closing the calotte, I'm fixing the crimp and open the calotte as much as I can, just to make fixing crimp comfortable. And now I make a knot over the crimp and pull it down as close to the crimp as possible. If you didn't succeed, if your knot is not perfect, if you see the extra space between crimp and knot, so just make another knot over the first one. It won't look nicely, but you will hide it underneath the calotte. So we're done. And now we'll start preparing the chain for the bracelet. I will need the two sizes of rings. As usual, I have all the rings and round rings. So let's make a chain. I'm gonna make a first segment. Just open the oval ring and link two small rings. And close the oval ring, and now I have a segment. So you can make a long chain as long as you need by making segments and then connecting segments together. So I do the second segment. And now I connect two segments together. There we are. The chain is ready. Now I will connect it with callot by other ring. So I put the ring in the callot. Callot has two holes together, and I put the ring in both holes and link the chain. And now I'm going to decorate the chain a little bit. You can use a small charm, small pendant, or a one bead matchable with your bracelet. I will have a lapis lazuli 1 cm bead, and I use the pink. So I'm taking the pin and put the bead on it. Now I could make many loops as I did in last lesson, and then link it to the chain by opening last ring or add one more ring, but I will just cut it and make a curl. When you're making two loops or more, it gives you more guarantee that the bead will never be lost. It's more safe way. But one ring looks more accurate, more tidy, and well, it's up to you how you're gonna make it. So that's how we decorated the chain, and from the other side we will link lobster locket. Now I will take the ring, open it, and do the same simple action from opposite side of the bracelet. Yeah. Okay, the bracelet is finished. Very stylish, beautiful, expensive stones. Now I will open the lobster locket by pulling down and close it, and that's how it looks like. So if the chain is down on your arm and it's moving from one side to other, and if it has decoration like charm or bead, it looks very, very lovely. Okay, the bracelet is ready, and I will see you in a few moments when we're gonna make a charming earrings. Welcome back, and now we will create the earrings fits to the bracelet. I will use the same beads. The design is very simple, just I want to show you how to use Murano glass beads in creating earrings. The process is the same as with the bracelet. Principally, the Murano glass beads must be stuck between two other beads. We need to fix them. So first I take the lapis lazuli big bead, beautiful navy color. Unfortunately, the camera doesn't show all the colors of beads. Then I put Murano glass bead and pre-knit bead. The only one useful trick you need to remember here is that you have to put down all the beads. They must not slide on pin. That's why I pull them all down, hold the pin by pliers and make a curl. Try to fix them all. Now I will show you the special craft for ears. I suggested you to take hooks. They are very popular, but also I want to show you this craft. I'm not sure how to call it in English, but we call it ear pins. Very comfortable wearing. It has a silicone stopper from the other side to control the ear pin in the ear. The ring for linking to the earring on this locket is not opening, so I need to open the hook and then link it, or add the opening ring by connecting them together. So it's up to you. You can make many loops. Actually, for beginners it's even more simple to you see, my one is sliding, so I will have to fix them properly. I will do it a bit later. If you do like two or three loops, if you use long pins and just your scrolling the pliers down, it will give you more chances that you will fix the beads better. Try this style and then connect it with the if you have like this ear pins, connect them by opening ring. But if you have hooks, you don't have to worry about hooks. Have an opening ring, so you will just connect them as usual. Just I want to show you as many crafts as I have, just to give you extra knowledge, but this is not necessary to buy them right now. So I'm fixing the other earring because the Murano glass bead was sliding. Now they are ready, and now I'm making sure that the length of the both earrings is the same, that they are the same. Very lovely beads, classical style, and Murano beads are very visible from all sides. The wonderful flowers in it. And now you see all set together. Hopefully, yes, your set is as lovely, as beautiful as mine. So enjoy yourself, enjoy jewelry, join to me to the next lesson. See you next time and have fun. Bye.